In this tutorial, we're going to cover how to make an NPC follow a path in our game world. We're going to make this a predefined path, but having this structure, you'll be able to expand on this and make random paths or have a bunch of paths. So let's get right on into it. First things first is I have a NPC, which I'm calling Town NPC, and she already has a Sprite2D setup and an animation player, which has basic idle and walk animations. So I just have those set up so we can get right into the path following. So the two things that we're going to have to add to our NPC, first one is going to be a path2D, and then as a child of that, we're going to have a path follow2D. We're going to need both of these as onReady variables. I'm going to rename this one to path and path follow2D to just path follow, and then we're going to have two configurable export variables. The first one is going to be move speed, which is going to be a float. I'm going to put this higher just so we can see her move around pretty quickly. And then I'm going to have an export variable for loop path, which is a boolean. We're going to default to true, so this can be used if you want your NPC to keep looping or if you want them to stop at the end. And then we're going to have a last position, which is a vector 2. We're going to use this for our movement tracking. So before we go and write the rest of this code, we're actually going to go back into our example scene here. This is the one that I'm going to be using. We will just click and drag her in here. And then we want to right click and we want to hit editable children, because we want to have access to these nodes, because we need to click in to our path2D, and up in the toolbar, we need to select this add point bit. And what I'm going to do is give her the first point here. I'm going to have her walk to through the bridge over here, back here, and then we are going to hit this one to just close the curve. Okay, now we can save this. And now we can go back into our town NPC script. So we can click her, go back to the script, and we're going to need our ready method, and we're going to need our physics process method. So I already have update animation. This is just very basic animation handling. We're not using an animation tree. We're just going to be using our animation player. So in our ready, we need to set the initial position of our NPC, and I'm opting to have her map to the first point in the path follow. So the path follow, we're going to get the global position. So I can place her wherever I want in the scene, but I do want to reset her position based on the path that we're making. And then we're going to make our last position be equal to that position now. And that's all we're going to have to do in the ready. And then in our physics process, we want her to move along the path. So we're going to go to our path follow. We're going to get the progress. We're going to plus equals our move speed and then multiply by delta. Then we're going to get the position. And it's going to be equal to our path follow dot global position. Then we want to check for movement so we can update our animations. So we're going to do a variable for movement. We're going to equal to our position minus the last position. Then if our movement length is greater than 0.1, we're going to update animation, we're going to pass in movement, and then outside of this if, we're going to do our last position and equal position. And now that we have all this done, this is all we're going to need. So now we can go and we can play this scene. Oh, let me make sure we're in the example scene. Now when I play this, she's walking really quickly just because that's how I have it set, but now she is on a looping path. So just remember that this is a starting point. This is not supposed to be all that you want to do with this. You can add interaction areas, you can have a dialogue system, you can have specific schedules for these players, you can add stops at each point, but this is just a very basic setup for you to get your NPCs following a path.